When it comes to selecting batteries for your system, there's a lot to consider. And although server rack and wall mount batteries are just batteries, they're actually far from the same. There's a ton to consider when you're trying to make a decision, and what type you should go with isn't always an easy choice. So welcome back to Lab Guys, where our opinions cannot be bought. Today, we're gonna be using the EG4LL server rack batteries, as well as the EG4 Power Pro wall mount battery as our examples, but this kind of applies to all server rack and all wall mount batteries. We'll go ahead and leave some links and discount codes to all the stuff that we're talking about, any batteries that we would recommend to you guys in the description down below, but let's not waste any time. Let's jump into the pros and cons of each of these guys. When it comes to server rack batteries, they all generally look about the same. They're all about 5,000 watts in storage, and they're designed to be stacked just like they are right here inside of this cabinet. A lot of other people put them on just like a random shelf like this, and they just kind of stack them on top of each other. In a scenario like this, they just basically slide right in onto the shelf. All of the batteries run over into the bus bar that's tucked right in behind this. Everything is stackable, modular, and just super clean and easy to navigate. Most cabinets have wheels on the bottom, and you can get the cabinets in either 3 batteries or 6 batteries as a pretty standard size. So if you have something like this that's full, you're gonna have about 30 kilowatts of storage. So starting with the pros, I would say that the biggest pro and the most visible, obvious thing that's going on right here is that you can start now and grow later. And this is a perfect example of that. You can just buy the batteries you can afford and start building your system. And as you can afford to add on to it one by one, you can continue to get batteries. So right now, we still have 2 holes in this cabinet. And as we can afford to get 2 more batteries, we'll throw 2 more in and we'll have that much more storage. But we're already started, we're already moving, we're already making progress. Another pro is that once you have a full setup like this, you can service them individually, you can replace only one, you can mix and match like we have right here. This is 2 EG4 LL batteries and 2 of the EG4 V2 Life Power 4 batteries. We can put 2 completely different EG4 batteries up top. All the ID and protocol settings are set to communicate with each other. And similarly, if say this battery fails, we don't lose the entire system. We just lose that battery. We can replace it individually while the rest of the batteries are still hard at work. You can also, kind of the reverse of what I just said, you can go ahead and attack these with power if you wanted to. If your inverter is putting in, say, 10,000 watts, that's enough to charge 2 batteries in 1 hour. You could disconnect the bottom 2 batteries out of this and charge them with a completely different method if you just really need to get power into this. You could basically charge all these batteries individually and charge the entire system within like 1 hour if you had the means to do so. Something else that's cool with server rack batteries is they come in voltage options. You can get this exact same battery in a 12, 24, or 48 volt. It's the exact same casing, it's all the exact same cells, they're just wired differently to give you a different voltage. So no matter what system you're trying to achieve, you can have this exact same setup. Server rack batteries also serve a ton of different purposes. You could bolt that to the floor of your RV, your camper van, you could put it in a boat, a little bit not water rated, but you could put it in a boat. You can do all kinds of stuff with a server rack battery. You can also put it in a cabinet like this, but you don't have to. Another pro with the server racks is you can buy a cabinet like this, which saves you. Like I said, if you had it on a shelf, you're gonna have your wires everywhere. A cabinet like this actually saves you from having to see the mess of wires that you have. It makes everything tidy. All the wires are short, easy, simple to understand. And when you close this, all you're gonna have is basically your one set of finalized wires going over to your inverter or whatever. And finally, when you compare one of these server rack batteries to a wall mount, it's just more manageable and easier to move around. Is it fun? No, it's 100 pounds, but it's not 300 pounds and it has handles and it's just, I can pick it up and move it around if I have to. The wall mount, I cannot. So this battery is the EG4 Power Pro. This is the all-weather option. It's a 280 amp hour battery with a 14 kilowatt storage capacity. So there's a lot going on right here. It comes with a bracket to mount it up to the wall. It also has nice little rubber feet on the bottom so that it sits nice and securely on the floor. It weighs 1 million pounds and you can get them both outdoor and indoor rated. And when it comes to pros, honestly, the first one is that this costs the exact same as the equivalent amount of server rack batteries. So this is no more expensive, but you get a lot more like bang for your buck with this. It's a lot smaller, simpler of a package. Everything is all right here, takes up far less room. It's a smaller footprint, but even not just this battery specifically, Wall mounts generally just take up less room. If they're a little bit smaller and you can mount them up on the wall, that frees up floor space even more. Generally, you're gonna get a much smaller, slimmer, more efficient package with less wiring and less stuff going on. But even not just this battery specifically, wall mounts generally just take up less room. You don't need the extra purchase of a cabinet like you do with the server rack batteries. There's just a lot less moving pieces and it's easier for the everyday person to kind of navigate this system. Server rack batteries are also not all sunshine and rainbows though. And the first con is that if you don't buy a cabinet, all your wires are gonna be exposed. It's gonna look super shitty. And it's just gonna kind of cause you stress just looking at it. So the cabinet is an extra expense. They're about 550 bucks, I think. But they're basically mandatory, so you don't have to look at all of this going on. It's just nice, clean, and done. It's also maybe more intimidating to someone who's not familiar with solar or electricity or anything like that due to all the extra wires and cables and communications and all that kind of stuff that goes into these batteries, setting up all the protocols one after the other so each battery knows where it is in the positioning. It could be a lot more daunting to someone that's brand new. It also has a much bigger footprint than a wall mount battery. It's a much wider box. It has to be as long as a server rack battery and have all this room in front for you to do the wiring and the bus bar connections. They also leave space in between each one so you can get some airflow and stuff going on in there. So it ends up being a significantly taller thing as well. So when it comes to trying to save room, a cabinet or just server rack batteries in general aren't gonna save you much room. They're actually gonna cost you room. When it comes to cons of this giant city tower though, the first one is gonna be that it is damn near impossible to move alone. It's 300 pounds. It's hard to move, period. Which also means it's hard to install. Picture yourself trying to actually mount this to a wall, never mind trying to get this into your basement or up or down a set of stairs. If your solar setup isn't somewhere where the FedEx guy can just drop your pallet and you can unbox it and then just move it across the garage floor and put it there, you're not gonna have fun trying to move this thing around. The next con is that you do still need a little bit of an extra piece with this. Generally, you're gonna wanna get a conduit box that goes around the top. All of your wires and everything are gonna run kind of up into that box and you're gonna use it to then direct all your wires and stuff somewhere else. It just helps keep the system a little bit cleaner. It's another 100 bucks a battery basically for that conduit box. And it kind of renders them non-stackable on top of each other. I'm sure you could do it, but it wouldn't look very clean. It wouldn't look very like professional. So if you're gonna use a system like this, you're gonna end up running them side by side with the conduit boxes on top, and you're gonna end up using a lot more wall space than you might have anticipated. Another honestly really big one is the potential failure of this battery means the entire battery is hooped. So if you have a server rack system and you have one battery that goes bad, you're down 5,000 watts, but you still have the rest of your batteries. If you have this and something goes wrong inside of it, the whole thing is out of commission. Now, sure, you may have a few of these, but you're losing them 14 kilowatts at a time if you have more than one. If you just have one, that's it. So at the end of the day, wall mount batteries are best suited for a home with limited space and a smaller energy need, or a insanely large energy need, I guess. And on the other hand, a server rack setup like this is better for a home with tons of extra space and one that needs just endless amounts of storage. To make it make more sense, a real life example, I'm building a greenhouse at my house. I would use this exact battery in that greenhouse. It's small, it's slim, it's not gonna take up much room in there, and it's gonna provide me tons of storage for the size of what it is. If I were putting my entire house off grid, I would probably go with something like this because I'm able to have just multiple cabinets full of batteries. I have enough room in my garage or my basement to put them, and I can afford to build my way into the system. So I can buy what I can afford right now, and as I can continue to afford stuff, or as my energy needs increase, I can always very easily just upgrade $12.99 at a time, basically, to continue to grow my system. So if you're still undecided, honestly, I would just call someone like Shop Solar or Signature Solar, speak to them about your needs and your wants and see what kind of products and stuff that they have to offer. But hopefully you guys have a little bit of a better understanding of what each of these is good for and which one is best for you. So that is all we got for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.